here are my top 7 tips that I've learned over the last year running this laser welder, cutter, and laser cleaner. I've had this laser welder for over a year. It's been amazing. I really think if you are owning a fabrication shop, this piece of equipment is going to become necessary to stay competitive in the future. Also, if you're thinking about starting a fab shop, I would highly recommend looking at this because you can offer something that a lot of people in your local area do not have. Increase your productivity, and it's also going to have a better product in the end compared to TIG or MIG. I would highly recommend buying one of these welding helmets that's meant for laser welding. The laser safety glasses are only there to protect the laser light reflection back into your retinas, blocking that light. Your laser welding helmet has that protection from the laser light, but also has a normal welding shield. And then the welding shield actually is around a 5 to about 9 shade. And the reason it's lighter than that is that weld pool is bright, where when you're looking at it with just regular the laser safety glasses, it hurts. But with that lighter shade welding, it will actually let you see the weld pool, and it helps tremendously because you're welding blind if you're not using that. A normal welding shield you don't want to use because it doesn't have the protection from the laser light. Face shields that's meant for laser welding. In the settings, the machine that usually comes with preset settings for the thickness material and the type of material you use. I highly recommend using that, but the two things I usually change on that, the width of the pattern that you're using, circle or side-to-side pattern or circle pattern, I like to usually increase that to about 0.5 millimeter bigger than what it comes with. I like it because it gates a lot of more material on the sides to the weld pool. And it slows down the process. Also, I like to slow the wire feed down about 2 millimeters, and that just seems like it's a comfortable speed for me. I'm sure the weld pool is doing what it needs to, and then the wire feed is, you know, not pushing me too quickly, because the wire will push the gun at the speed that it wants to go. Also, on the settings, I particularly like the either side to side or the round function. Every other function I haven't been really too pleased with. But the round function is really what I like to use because it gives you kind of more of a stacked dime look, cleaner weld. I've just had the best luck with the round function. I've noticed that it slows you down a little bit. So if you're looking for speed, I'd go back to the cross function. The technique's really similar to MIG welding. If the pieces are really close together, you see in a lot of other videos, by just dragging material, letting the wire feed your speed, the machine do its deal. Pretty straightforward. You know, if it's a butt joint, you have to make sure that your head is at a correct angle, because if not, you're going to be welding, heating up more material here than here. So, you know, a 45 degree angle. The machine only goes in one direction. I've been able to go left or right, but that just comes with practice. If you're filling a gap, use the J technique, where you're heating up the thicker part of the metal and you're pushing the wire into the gap. Also, you know, speed up your wire feed. I usually can speed up the wire feed about 2 millimeters to fill up a 1/8 inch gap pretty easily. Gas flows. This machine uses more gas flow than a typical MIG or TIG process. MIG or TIG process, you're using maybe 15 to 20 SCFM, where this is, you're using about 50 SCFM of nitrogen or what other gas you're using, and it's all to keep the protective lens clean. I haven't found any issues with the weld pool being too cooled by the gas, so your gas flow is always directed or determined by basically the wattage you're using. And 50 SCFM is what I found to be good for about, you know, 500 to 1,000 watts. And then when you get above 1,000 watts, you want to increase that 5, 10 SCFM until when you get to about 1,500 watts, 2,000 watts. 2,000 watts is the machine I have. For cutting, use as much air pressure as you can from your compressors. Also, you want it to go through a microfilter. And then I use a refrigerated air dryer you want that air to be as clean as possible, just like even more cleaner than plasma cutting, because you don't want any sort of moisture or particulates getting on that window, because if it does, it will instantly burn up that window. For welding with like mild steel, you can use compressed air, and I use about 25 PSI through a regulator, still through that microfilter to weld with that. Mild steel. Stainless steel, you need nitrogen, aluminum, argon, things of that nature. Consumables. From the welding consumables, protective glass is what you go through. And it all depends on really getting your gas flows right with the wattage you're using. Make sure your gas is clean. You know, you want to use 99.9% nitrogen, and make sure your welding shop is selling you the higher purity gases for that. Also your flow. If your flow is not good, you're going to burn up those protective glasses, and they're about $6 to $7 a piece. And you get them Amazon, eBay, from the manufacturer. But the copper tips, I haven't replaced mine yet for the welding. Make sure that the wire guides are set for that wire, because you don't want that wire to be wandering out of the laser pool. But for the cutting, I've been able to find these tips that are 1.2 diameter. And the reason that that's really nice is increasing the airflow velocity into the cut, that reduces the slag. It's not gonna get rid of the slag, but watch my other video about how I was able to pick up a drum sander to get rid of the rest of the slag. That keeps you from having to invest in a different type of head. These heads can only do about 110 PSI. Get dross feed cutting for a laser cutter. You need a dedicated laser head that you could put on this machine, but they're also requiring about 200 to 250 PSI of high flow air. If you want to just keep the actual laser head that comes with the machine and able to put it on like a CNC plasma table like I did, you know, check out the video in the description, you know, you're just going to have to deal with a little bit of dross. But use as small of a cutting nozzle as you possibly can. Laser alignment. For the welding, you want the laser alignment, either the cross or the round, be in the center of the wire. If it's not in the center of the wire, then the wire will start sticking to your material, and it's going to become a headache, because every time you stop welding, it's going to be stuck and drive you nuts. Make sure the laser is around the actual wire feed and make sure it's centered. With the alignment of the laser for the cutting, you want to put the nozzle on, put a piece of clear packing tape on the tip of the nozzle, and then direct the nozzle or the laser light so it's centered, using have your protective glasses on if you're looking at the laser. But you want it to be centered in that nozzle. If not, you'll blow right through the nozzle and it will cause a lot of problems. For safety, always wear eye protection, and also wear a respirator and have highly ventilated areas. This laser welder and cutter basically vaporizes that material to a very fine dust, and you do not want to breathe that in. Respirators, a lot of ventilation, keep that stuff out of your lungs. Thanks for tuning in. Check out my other videos. I've put this laser cutter on a CNC plasma cutter or a CNC plasma table. And the detail and cutting ability I've gotten out of that is awesome. Check out that video. Also check out the video of the drum sander that I was able to pick up for woodworking and basically use it to remove the laser dross. And also my other videos, I built a fixture table with this laser cutter and welder, which turned out really neat. Thanks. Comment, like, and subscribe, because I'm going to be putting a lot of content up for laser welder and other things I do. Thanks.